Hi everyone, in this video, we shall see how to configure a cross-region data guard for 23 AI-based database. I'm Sneha and let's get started. Oracle Database 23 AI is the next long-term support release and includes more than 300 additional major features focused on simplifying the use of AI with data running mission-critical workloads. Oracle Database 23 AI seeks to bring AI algorithms to where the data lives, instead of having to move the data to where the AI algorithm lives. Now, this approach can allow AI to run in real time in Oracle databases and potentially improve the effectiveness, efficiency, and security of AI. Thus, provides mission-critical data assurance that is essential to accelerating adoption of Gen AI capabilities. As more mission-critical data becomes intertwined with AI functionalities, the business needs a robust and automated disaster recovery. So in the next few minutes, I will show how to create an Oracle Database 23 AI, configure data guard, and also how you could perform a role change to avoid downtime for planned and unplanned outages. A data guard implementation requires two DB systems, one containing the primary database and one containing the standby database. When you enable data guard for a database, a new DB system with the standby database is created and associated with the primary database. Refer to the link here for prerequisites and general information. The documentation also mentions on additional requirements on some known issues. Now, specific to cross-region data guard, here are some important requirements. Firstly, establish remote VCN peering between the regions. Now, remote VCN peering connects VCNs in different regions to allow resources to communicate using private IP addresses over the Oracle backbone network without routing the traffic over the internet. Follow this documentation to peer your VCNs in the different regions. Then enable network traffic to flow between the VCNs. For this, open the TCP port 1521 to allow Oracle Data Guard redo transport to flow between the primary and standby database. Add the appropriate security list and route table rules to your subnets in both regions to allow TCP traffic over port 1521 in both directions. Then enable Data Guard. So after the VCNs appeared and network traffic is allowed to flow between the VCNs, you can enable the data guard using the OCI console. Let's start by provisioning a base database 23 AI. Click on Create DB System, enter your DB system name, select the shape. I'm selecting Intel here with 2 OCPUs per node. Enter your storage details, your license. So I have selected extreme performance because I will be creating an active data guard. Specify the network information, your VCN, your client subnet, host name prefix. Click on next. Provide the database information like your database name. Now here in the database version, select 23 AI. Provide the password details. If you want to configure backup, provide the backup details. Okay, then click on Create DB System. So you can see now that the database is being provisioned. So you can check the work request here. So as you can see, the Create DB System has completed successfully. Let's enable the data guard association for the Oracle Database 23 AI. So go to the database details page. So if you see here, the status is not enabled under data guard. So go to data guard associations, click on enable data guard and fill in all this information. So create the DB system. So I select my cross region. In my case, I've selected Amsterdam. specify the network information. Ensure that the regions are paired. Okay, now for cross region, you can only select the maximum performance protection when you configure it from the UI. Okay, so the status is turned as updating. And if you see here, the active data guard is being created. So you can monitor the work request. So as you see here, the work request has been successfully completed and the data guard has been created in the Amsterdam region. So you can see the details under the data guard association. Now let's do a role change. We'll start with the switchover. So you connect to the primary, go to the database, click on data guard associations, click on switchover. Provide the sys password. The database will now be in an updating state. So the primary will now be converted to a standby database and the standby in Amsterdam will be converted to a primary database. So you can click on the work request and monitor the work request. So as you can see, the switchover has been completed successfully. And if you click on the data guard association, in Amsterdam, the role has changed to a primary database. We will now do a failover. This is usually done when there is a real disaster and you want to activate the standby database. So again, we go to the data guard association. So as you see that the previous primary is now a standby database. So at the standby side, you go to data guard associations and click on failover. Enter the sys password and click on OK. You can monitor the work request. Okay, so as you see, the failover is successful, and we shall now see how to reinstate the failed standby database, which is now as a disabled standby. Okay, so after the failover, the database role has changed to primary. Okay, in the data guard associations, you will see that the standby has gone into a disabled state. So this standby is now in Amsterdam. So if there's any major issue, you can fix the issue and then you can click on this reinstate option. Okay, so again from the primary side, I go to the data guard associations. As you see, the peer role is disabled standby. Just click on reinstate. Provide the sys password and click on OK. You can again monitor the work request. Okay, so as you see here, the work request is successful. So go back to your data guard associations. And if you see from disabled standby, the peer role is now standby. So if you see in Amsterdam, the database role has changed to standby after reinstate. Thank you for watching.